As you have said that a lot of fields are already being benefited from this technology, 3D printing, including medical sciences, space sciences, manufacturing engineering and all others. So we thought, why not structural engineering? So we have come up with some applications of 3D printing technology in structural engineering, and we have started it by printing our three-dimensional structural models, which are made for structural analysis. They look something like this. What we have done is that our normal procedure for structural analysis is that we create simulation models in computers, and we subject them to earthquakes and check what is going to happen to them, how will they behave in anticipated ground motions and ground shakings. So we have already created an app called CSI eTabs Viewer, which has the capacity to convert our three-dimensional structural models, we call them finite element models, into the format which can be directly printed in 3D printer. So our app looks like something this. You can see a structural model vibrating in its fundamental sway mode. Using this app, we are able to print three-dimensional deflected models. For example, you can see this model, which shows the fundamental sway mode of a 9-story reinforced concrete building, and one is already being printed. So we can come up with some instructional or conceptual models, some damage illustrations for educational purposes, and we also can ultimately create physical testing models, reduced scale or large small scale models, which we can test in wind tunnels and shake tables. So our ultimate target is to create physical models in 3D printers which can be tested right away in strong winds and earthquakes.
And how cost effective or affordable is this?
Usually the physical models which we used for reduced scale testing in wind tunnels and shake tables, they cost a lot. And introduction of this technology in creating those models will significantly reduce its cost, as well as its minor details, its efficiency, as well as the actual distribution of mass and stiffness. So we can come up with a lot of new ways to use this technology in structural engineering.